Hello, everybody, and welcome to the session of Through the Eyes of Generation Z Young Women. Today, I have three high school young women with me, and we're going to be shooting questions to them. Please add questions of your own to the chat window as it comes up. And this is the only live session at this time, so this will be fun. So I want to give you a little background of this, but I want everyone to know that this session was not rehearsed. The idea of this session is they have a feeder question to make these three young women feel comfortable. But after that, it is solely questions from the audience, unrehearsed, and you want to get the opinion of high school girls about STEM careers and what they can get to. And I'll tell you the genesis in a second, but I just want to introduce these three remarkable young women. First up is actually one I'm very proud of. I'm proud of all three of them, but is my daughter, Jaden Cooper. Jaden, say hi.
Hi.
Next up is Carmela Dunn. Carmela.
Hi.
And last but not least is Lindsay Rea. Lindsay.
Hi.
All right. So three young women, two sophomores, one junior, all very interested in STEM careers, but all very multidisciplinary. And I want to give you a little background about this and why we had this. So a couple years ago, we created a video that actually went viral, made it to the White House, was tweeted by Trump, and it was about girls in STEM, and it showed it. From that, I had the idea of promoting amazing, unique careers. NSF and the community colleges allowed myself and a lot of our students to go into amazing places that most people don't get to see. And so I went into a nuclear power plant and made a video interviewing someone, a young person that worked there. I went into a solar field and did the same thing. But then when I showed it to high school students, I realized they didn't want to see an ugly 40-something-year-old man on camera talking about those careers. They wanted to see it from the eyes of themselves. And quite frankly, the questions I would ask are very different. My optics are very different than these three young women. And I was shocked by that. When I look at something, I see the complexity of it. I see the just how it fits into the full ecosystem. And quite frankly, I see the dollar figure associated with it. When I take my daughter to that same thing, she views it through such a beautiful lens, and Carmela and Lindsay as well, when they see it, it's a different lens they view it through. They view it with untapped potential. They look at the technology, and I was quite amazed that they also look at it as being clean, green, and how it can help the world. This new generation not only looks at how to advance things, but how to like correct social injustice. And a lot of this channel is about how to bring more girls into STEM fields. So we realigned the channel to have these three young women interview other young women in STEM disciplines, technician women that have graduated community colleges. Next week, they interview a young lady that graduated out of Indian River State program and is at the largest producer of alternative energy in the world. And she helps actually set up the solar fields now. After that, they're going to a crime field, and there's a ton of technology that goes into a crime analysis. And from there, there's going to be more and more clips, and they're going to interview some social pioneers, women on YouTube. And we're hoping at the very end of this session that you go and subscribe to their channel on YouTube. I'm going to put that in the chat window for everyone, and you promote it for them. And over the course of this next year, there's going to be 8 clips at 8 amazing locations, a couple with social pioneers. And these young girls, we're going to see the experience through their eyes. Even in setting this up and working with them, what I've noticed is my perception is wrong. I've been in academia for a long time, and a lot of us on this call today can know that it's very hard to move that needle. I mean, we're stuck at something like 27% of the working force in STEM fields is women, and that needle's not moving. We had to listen to these young women like them, but what moves that needle? So the questions that I'm gonna throw at them are questions to try to help us, the people that have seen it one way, listen to the next generation, listen to them, and really get quite engaged from them. So you girls ready to get started with some questions?
Yeah.
Yes. All right, Carmela, you were the first one to say yes. So I'm going to ask you first, Carmela. I want you to tell us a little about where you live, what your interests are, what career paths you want. And I'll ask you and talk and like try to segment it. Like when I was in elementary school, I want to do this. When I was in middle school, I want to do this. Now that I'm in high school and I'm a crazy teenager, because I have one, I want to do this. And tell us why, like what are the drivers? So spend a couple minutes and tell us, Carmela.
Okay, so I live in Alpharetta, Georgia, which if you don't know what Alpharetta is, basically it's near Atlanta. And I'm a sophomore in high school. And so originally my like career path when I was in elementary school, it was just like kind of jobs that everyone wanted to be. So maybe like a firefighter or like a compute. Like I also wanted to be a computer scientist at one point, just because I got really into doing like PowerPoints and stuff like that. And then once I merged more into like middle school, I took a healthcare science pathway courses. So I wanted to be a neuroscientist, and neuroscientist specifically because of the money they make, but I wanted to be in healthcare. And then last year, when I was like doing my healthcare science pathway, and it just didn't interest me as much anymore. And so I decided that I'd rather take up, and math and science were getting more interesting to me. So I decided that I'd rather take up a role in like maybe an engineering undergrad with like a business overgrad or any other overgrad, like a master's. I'm not sure which one yet, but like I definitely want to get an engineering undergrad.
It's a really good transition, Carmela. Thank you for thank you for being honest and saying there was a money element in this consideration of it. Which one of you young ladies would like to go next? Tell us about your transition from K through what, 11. Jaden, why don't you tell us?
Okay, as a kid, I wanted to be an engineer or scientist like my parents. And then I went into middle school and I went into a little fantasy of becoming an actress. After middle school, I went to high school, and really I ended up becoming more critical of a lot of careers, and now I'm unsure, but I have many career paths in mind, one of film because I still love theater. I also have a career path of being a lawyer in mind, and as well as psychology and some more cognitive behavioral psychology.
I've learned more about you than I have over the last couple of weeks. So thank you, Jaden. And last, again, is Lindsay. Lindsay, tell us about your thoughts on this whole process.
I am in 10th grade in Fort Pierce, Florida. I am interested in majoring in bioengineering. In like kindergarten, I wanted to be normal things like a doctor or a lawyer. And then once I got into middle school, I wanted to be a teacher. And then later in the middle school, I wanted to be a surgeon. And then last year I took a biology class and I thought it was so cool. And I just always liked science. And so I think medical and then like engineering would be really, really, really cool.
Okay, it's nice to get to know all three of you. My next question again is for you, Lindsay, so stay on. I want you to tell us like what influences you, what drives you, like what, like people, websites, neighbors, friends, families, you know, just a random person, a random story you read. What is your biggest influences on this? You know, there's some emerging themes I see among you already, but go on, Lindsay, tell us some more.
Okay, so I have a family member who used to work in the STEM field, and I thought it was so cool. Like, she used to work at the power plant, and I thought it was cool. And then my mom has probably been the biggest influence, more so because she has worked with the college and in STEM. And she's always talked about all the amazing jobs and all the amazing opportunities you get with the jobs, and how there's so many available for young women in STEM, like us three girls. And I've always been eager to be one of those girls to get a job in the STEM field. And I honestly believe that if it wasn't for my mom to tell me about all these amazing job opportunities and jobs available for young girls in STEM, I don't think I'd be on the STEM call right now.
Where would you be? What path would you go?
Just being a normal kid at school, doing work. Like, I don't think I'd have this awesome opportunity.
Okay. You wouldn't have this type of focus on.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So it's interesting because I know Carmela's parents, I know your parents, I know Jaden's parents, and you're picking these fields and you have it in your background. Carmela, answer the same question. Tell us a little about it, your influencers and drivers, and if there's any particular thing that stands out.
Okay. So basically, both of my parents have engineering undergrads and master's degrees. They have different engineering, like they both have different engineering degrees, but they both have a master's of business. And like, as I've gotten older, I've looked at their work more like closely, and I like enjoy it. And I think that what they do is like super cool. And what I like about it especially is that they're allowed to have like a, that they have like an engineering background, but at the same time, they're also doing like sales and business, and they get to like communicate with other people and talk about that. So that aspect of it is interesting to me. And then also, I think it's just like what everyone else around you is doing. So like, as we get older, more people are starting to get involved in like engineering as well, or like different categories. So like listening to what everyone else has to say about a certain career also like influences your career pathways.
Okay, good answer, Carmela. What about, answer it also from the perspective of your peers, not just yourself, like what you see with your peers, like peers that are not.
I think that with our peers, especially,
your it's friends. Really, do you have friends, Carmela?
Yeah, I do. Okay. I think it's heavily influenced by, so at our school, we have like four career pathways, I think. So there's like engineering, healthcare science, I think theater, and then like, AV tech or like video. So I think those, when we got into high school, that started to drive everyone, because you like picked a career path to do. And so that kind of just like learning about that more, like started to drive people in different directions. And then I also think that social media has a big influence on a lot of people, because they see someone, like if you see who someone famous has a certain degree, you're like all of a sudden like, oh my gosh, I kind of want to look into that, or that sounds like a cool job. So I think it really just depends on the atmosphere of like maybe the school you go to, teachers, what, so like the best teachers, like if you have a really good teacher for a certain class, that often influences you to kind of want to dig deeper into that class or in that career choice, versus if your teacher for that class was not a very good teacher, it doesn't make you really want to do that career path. So I think it has to do with that.
It's a real good question. Jaden, are we boring you? We're going to come back to you on the social media, because I know you are addicted, and we're still going to watch The Social Dilemma at some point in time. But I wanted to follow up just a little bit more on that to you, Lindsay or Carmela, both of you perhaps. So your friends' parents that aren't into STEM, How do you influence them? How do others influence them? You know, versus social media, is there a peer influence? Is that at all in play? Lindsay, I assume you also have friends, maybe? Two? Okay, well, tell us how you help those two friends of yours.
Okay, so I was talking to my best friend about it, and she thought it was super cool. And I think I started to like make her more interested in it, because she kept on asking me questions about it and asking like, what jobs are there available and where are the available jobs and questions like that. And then I told her to watch our video, and she said that made her interest peak a lot, because she thought it was so cool that I got to do this stuff. And I think I have influenced my friends to go into the STEM field a lot because of just me talking about it all the time. And they haven't even gotten annoyed, so I'm guessing I'm interesting them.
Right. So I'm getting back to that, because that's like one of the purposes of the whole channel, right? Is you are peers and you're trying to influence your peers and want to get your perspective of that. But first I want to dig into this question with Jaden, really, which is the question is, I was born well before the cell phone, Instagram, internet, Facebook. I can live without it, believe it or not. I don't like them. But I want to know, how does it work? Does anything work, like to get people, like I watch a lot of YouTubes. I know you do as well. Does anything actually work to influence you, or to get views then to influence you? So tell me a little bit of your thoughts on the whole social media and social guidance thing, Jaden. And I know you're an expert in the field, so tell me.
So. Well, our platform is YouTube, and for YouTube, I think the best thing you can do is get people's interest fast. I would advise, the first things people see is clickbait and the time of your video. And both of those need to be appealing for someone to watch the video. And those are the first things I look at when I watch a video, because I have a short attention span and I'm not going to watch a 30-minute video about STEM. Maybe I'll watch a 5-10 minute one.
I don't even believe that. I don't think you'd watch more than 90 seconds. I think that one of the reasons we made a short video series at your guidance is people watch something short. But talk a little bit more. Give us an example there, Jaden. I don't think everyone knows what clickbait is or what you're talking about or making it a little exaggerated or like off topic to get on topic. Give us an example of what attracts interest. It doesn't have to be STEM. What attracts interest? Give an example of how it is clickbait, like switching bait.
Okay, one of my favorite YouTubers is known for doing clickbait. And one of the science-related ones is we had a huge explosion in our front yard. And so clickbait is the picture and the title. Clickbait is usually not necessarily true. It's slightly or related to the video topic. And it has to be the first thing that pulls people in. And for our videos, we're thinking if we go to the crime lab, we solve